Everyone in this room is inspired by you. Who are you inspired by?
Well, Kanye West, obviously.
There's a friend of mine who's got a good phrase for doing a startup. It's like eating glass and staring into the abyss. I don't know if that's probably not encouraging.
I look like an orange. Yeah, this isn't gonna work, is it? Welcome back to part two of a three-part series on high school entrepreneurship. If you are a student in school or college and you have an idea, you don't even know if the idea is great, but you're willing to work hard, you want to create something that's bigger than yourself, you want to create something that has an impact in society, then you've come to the right place. If you've not seen part one of this three-part series, then I will put that part one here or here, one of these corners. A few quick things before we start. I have now created a Discord server. I have linked that in the description. I don't really know how to use Discord, so if someone could help me out, that would be extremely helpful. You know, walk me through some of the basics. I don't even know the purpose of Discord, but from what I gather, it's a way for me to interact with you, my loyal subscribers. If you haven't subscribed. We're at like 18,600 right now, so please let me get to 20,000. I would be very, very grateful. I will actually post next week instead of taking a 1 week gap for no reason at all. The last thing I wanted to tell you, I will have the results of the SpectraVerse team shortlist, whether you sign up for the foundation team, the recruitment team, the e-learning module team, or the social media team. And I'll be telling you all of those names in the end of the video. So have fun and let's begin. 703 I5s, look alive, niggas came up on me. After you've had interviews, you've identified your stakeholders, you've come up with a business plan, you should start talking about your company. And what I mean by that is you should reach out to a few adults, you should reach out to maybe a few teachers in your school and tell them that you have this idea you want to work on and try to get some of their feedback. And they don't have to be related to your field, but sometimes adults can have really valuable experience and advice. So for example, I'd sent a mail to the principal of my school and I'd said, I have this business plan and I have this idea that I'm really excited about. Would you be willing to hear my business plan out? And maybe they won't be able to help your services directly, but in some cases they might be able to point you towards a different direction. They might be able to give you a few connections in their circles who might be helpful. So it's very important that you start talking about your idea so that you can hopefully find someone who'd be able to guide you down this journey. 703 I5s, look alive, niggas came up on this. Now is the time for you to reach out to your stakeholders and try to initiate a conversation. The first thing you should know when you're reaching out to any stakeholder you have. So for SpectraVerse, the two stakeholders were companies and NGOs. So these were two different poles that I was trying to connect with. The first thing you should know is that you have to narrow down your scope immediately. So for example, when you talk about companies, I could practically reach out to any company for SpectraVerse and be like, hey, would you want to hire a person with a disability? But that would be extremely inefficient because I'd just be cold mailing a bunch of organizations, not knowing if they'd reply to me or not. So the logic that I used was trying to understand which industries did people with disabilities historically have a decent amount of success rate with. And I narrowed it down to the hospitality industry. If you go to hotels sometimes, for example, Lemon Tree Hotel has a really strong network of differently abled candidates. If you look at the retail industry and the food and beverage industry, you'll notice that people with speech and hearing impairments and maybe locomotive impairments do quite well there. I remember once when I was about 12 years old, I'd gone to a KFC and the individual who was serving me had a speech and hearing impairment. And immediately I made those connections and I tried to remember all the kinds of companies that would potentially be open to hiring people with disabilities. The first thing you need to understand is that you have to use your age to your advantage. You are either a 15, 16, 17 year old entrepreneur, and that is a very interesting thing to see in any industry, especially for me when I was in the world of disability. And the first NGO that finally replied to my cold mail, I'd sent about 50 cold mails to different NGOs across a span of 3 months. The first NGO that replied to me, I'll put the mail over here, the first line, the founder pointed out that someone of my age was interested in this field. And that was my first hook. The fact that a 16 year old student was able to try and enter this field and see if they can make an impact. And a lot of the times you might look at your age as a disadvantage. A lot of people will be like, you haven't even graduated high school, why are you trying to start a company? Use that to your advantage. Use the fact that there's barely anyone trying to chase after the problem you're chasing at your age. Another thing that I realized with SpectraVerse that was really helpful was understanding what kind of a company would react positively to my entire message. If you've noticed, Gen Z as a generation and even millennials are a lot more socially inclined than other generations. And I try to understand whether startups in specific would look favorably towards hiring an individual with a disability. And when you go to 24, 25 year old founders, you'll notice very quickly that they are a lot more receptive to the idea of a diverse workplace, the idea of having minorities of different kinds being in their company. And you need to use that to your advantage. You need to notice what kinds of people would like to hire an individual with a disability. What kinds of people would be more receptive to the problem you're trying to tackle. And for me, that was definitely a startup. They won't be expecting shit when capital borders. One of the challenges I faced during the outreach phase was that it took me 4 months to place my first batch of 15 candidates. And the reason was that the company I was working with didn't see the service I was providing as a priority. They only saw it as a part of a CSR agenda or something that was basically good for the community. And this point is especially relevant for you if you're trying to do something for community service. It's not good enough for your work to be good for the community. You also have to show a company why there's business value in it, because that's the only way that they'd prioritize you. So for example, as a part of my pitch to companies, I began to talk about some of the economic benefits that hiring a person with a disability might have for a company. For example, you could have specific tax rebates. Another example is that people with disabilities have had statistically lower levels of attrition rates than a normal candidate. Attrition rate basically means the rate at which a candidate enters and leaves your company. And when you're in a company, especially if you're in a startup, you would want to have a loyal candidate base and a loyal employee base. And it was those kinds of conversations that actually generated me results. Another thing I found extremely helpful was that you should be extremely ambitious and extremely audacious when it comes to your company. You don't have to be the first person doing it. You don't have to even be the best person doing it at that point of time, but still set an extremely high goal for yourself. For example, when I first started SpectraVerse, I hadn't hired even one person with a disability. I hadn't given anyone a job. I hadn't worked with any NGO, but I still knew that I wanted to try and place 100 candidates with a disability. And to be honest, I still haven't reached that goal because I very quickly realized that it is very hard to give someone an actual job. And with COVID-19, it's become even harder. But the point is that you should be setting those kinds of goals for yourself so that it pushes you to try and do as well as you can. And if you fall short of it, so be it. It doesn't matter. The point is that you tried and you created some amount of impact along the way. We gon' see how hard they ride. I get racks to go outside and I spit it with the pad. Now, at about this time, you're going to realize that if you're creating a company like SpectraVerse or any product or service, you would want to have an actual product or service, which means that you're going to go through a product development phase. And it's very important for you, if you're the only entrepreneur involved, to write down the skills that you have to make something like this happen. For example, with me, for SpectraVerse, I wanted to create a recruitment platform, but I had zero coding abilities. And if you're not, you know, the kind of person who can code or can design or can do whatever it is your business is trying to do, you shouldn't really be discouraged because you can outsource literally everything. All I had to do for SpectraVerse was find an organization that was willing to code my website for me and was willing to be the technology backend of my website. And I would basically create templates on Wix out of all platforms in the world. I'd create a short template, I'd send a page to them and say, this is what I want it to look like. So you should never be discouraged from your lack of a hard skill, because there is always someone out there who'd be willing to help you for that. Even when you're initially communicating with companies and foundations, don't be afraid to create a mock-up page and send it to them, so that even if you don't have the solution right now, you can show them what your solution is likely to look like in the next 3 months. There's a common saying in entrepreneurship in general that, you know, perfect is the enemy of progress. And if you keep trying to perfect and refine your product or your service, you're never going to be able to hit the market. You're never going to be able to make any progress with it. So even if it is a really basic rudimentary model, it's very important for you to even show that kind of a model, so someone out there has some idea of what your company is trying to do. And I think that's very helpful. We up on the other side, niggas acting like we tied. I've been gone since like July. One thing I would discourage you from doing is creating an Instagram page, only for the reason that it sort of gives you validation before you've really done anything. A lot of people start businesses for 1 week, 2 weeks, and before they've really achieved anything, they're already trying to get Instagram followers. that is not the metric for your impact unless, you know, you're an organization that solely works on social media. Unless you need social media for, you know, later down the line when you want to show either a college that you've created a business or you want to expand your team and you want students to join your platform, I really don't find it as beneficial to start it right from the get-go. It is helpful further down the line, but you really don't need it in the beginning. It just detracts from the impact you're trying to make by giving you goals like followers, likes, and social media traction, which is just superficial at the end of the day. It really doesn't help you too much. These are the lists for the social media team, the foundations team, the e-learning team, and the recruitment team. I'll put them up in succession and I will tell you the names of those lists. If you made the shortlist, congratulations. We should have sent you a mail already. I'm gonna eat this watermelon now. If you didn't make the shortlist, don't worry about it. I will try to provide as many opportunities as I can, you know, as SpectraVerse scales up. A lot of the team that I had made throughout high school is now gone off to college and they don't really have time to be working on this, which is why I'm working with high school students right now through two high school students, Aniket and Agam, who are in the American Excelsior School and in the Dune School. So SpectraVerse should have a few exciting updates for you in the coming months, and I will be providing more opportunities for my company as well as other companies. And, you know, now that we have a Discord server, if anybody else has opportunities, feel free to offer them, feel free to self-promo your organizations, not blatantly, but be like subtle about it. Just be like, you know, I have this thing that you could do, but yeah, you get what I mean, right? Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in part 3, which will come out in a week, I promise. Like, okay, I take my promises very seriously. It'll come out in a week. Have fun, and goodbye.